Let's get right to it and talk tropics. A lot going on out there. Jose off our coast. It's going to be bringing some significant surf to the Outer Banks. Could have some minor beach erosion. Winds 35 to 45 miles an hour out there. That's it. Listen, we're not going to feel the effects here. Might get a little breezy today, and that's it. Now we'll turn our attention to Maria, potentially getting to a Category 4 storm. Path could impact the Bahamas. Then after that, it's anyone's guess. That's a long ways off, but you see how the models are bending it, heading towards the southeast United States, something we're going to keep a very close eye on. But first, let's get through Jose off our coast right now. There is a Hatteras, and you can see some of the outer bands are still well offshore. There's the center of circulation right now. You can see that lifting northward. A lot of dry air has been punching in on the backside of this storm. This is a water vapor, shows the mid-level dry air over us, and that's getting sucked right into the storm system, so likely it's going to be getting weaker as it lifts northward. The concern along our coast, the heavy surf, and from Hatteras all the way up towards Killdevil Hills, we could see some seas upwards of 14 feet tonight into tomorrow, and then those bigger swells are going to be lifting off to the north as a storm does too. We have warnings in effect from Ocracoke all the way through our coastline to Virginia Beach. Tropical storm warning, that is, from Ocean City northward. Tropical storm watches as Jose looks to be staying offshore. Meantime, we have two more storms out there. Lee falling apart and really going to be a non-issue. Maria, though, looks very impressive right now, and it looks to be moving into a favorable environment. The center here probably seeing an eye develop later on today. These are the Lesser Antilles, and it looks like they're going to get hit very hard with a Category 1 or 2 storm, and it'll get stronger from there. Winds at 90, gusts to 105 miles an hour, moving at a decent pace at 13 miles an hour, moving west-northwest, potentially up to a 4 as it moves somewhere near San Juan, Puerto Rico, near the Dominican Republic and Haiti, and then starting to see that northward turn as it gets close to the Bahamas still as a major hurricane, something we're going to keep a really close eye on over the coming days. All right, so look at the last 5 days. Numbers have been in the 80s, and if you like that, you're going to be in the 80s for quite a while, all the way through next weekend, potentially. 60s and humid this morning, 77 by midday. Areas of low clouds and some patchy fog in places, and the low clouds will break apart, and we'll see partly sunny skies later on, and 82. 85 tomorrow. Wednesday, quite warm, all the way up to 88. Some areas in the Sandhills could be 90. And the breeze today, anywhere from 10 to 15 miles an hour. Strongest breeze is going to be farther out to the east. So that's the only effects we're going to be feeling at all from Jose here in the heart of Carolina. Into Fayetteville we go, 68, a north breeze right now, 13 miles an hour. Mid-60s up in our northern counties, warmer to the south. And with no rain in the forecast, a good time to get that car wash today. Looks like numbers will be in the low 80s later on this afternoon. But again, I'm not forecasting rain all the way through the 7-day period. So Jose offshore, our breeze tomorrow will be coming in from the northwest. Then as we go into our Wednesday, a partly sunny day and warm. Numbers are going to be way up there, and there's still Jose just lingering off Nantucket. Your forecast for today, highs will be in the 80s, although lower 80s around the triangles, upper 70s in our northern counties. And then for tonight, we're in the mid-60s under partly cloudy skies. Might have some patchy fog tomorrow morning. First Alert AccuWeather 7-day forecast. The temperatures, well, they're going to go up. We're talking upper 80s midweek, well above the average. Autumn gets here on Friday at 4:02 in the afternoon, and even for the weekend, the first weekend of autumn, we're in the lower 80s with a mix of sun and clouds. Meantime,